Hi, my name is David Rosales. I'm the pastor of Calvary Chapel of the Chino Valley, California. When the United States originally began dealing with the coronavirus, the standard quarantine period was practiced, which is 14 days. The reason for the 14 days quarantine had to do with the way viruses invade and replicate. It takes about 5 days for COVID to incubate. About 97% of the people who get infected and develop symptoms will do so within 11 to 12 days, and about 99% will within 14 days. Because of this, 14 days was considered the outside safety margin. The quarantine, which originally was to be practiced until we saw the curve flatten, has now become public policy with no end in sight, and with the possibility of it extending until the end of the year. At this point, it would seem that the enemy has done his best to silence the witness of the church. I can't help but remember when Jesus made his triumphal entry into Jerusalem and how the leaders told Jesus to tell his disciples to quiet down. Well, it seems obvious that the devil still wants us to stop praising and worshiping Jesus. It also seems obvious that he's provoking government authorities to silence the church. This is to be understood, but what I don't understand is how easily many professing Christians have actually sided with closing down churches. Perhaps this is simply the observable purging of the church of its terrors. This uncertainty related to the virus has taken its toll and has impacted our nation dramatically. Depression, anger, family tension, drug, alcohol abuse, even suicide has increased. When people lose hope, they often suffer and struggle terribly. It has also hit the church in a dramatic way, with some churches unable to survive the quarantine. Before all of this happened, the United States was already seeing a decline in church attendance. According to a 2019 survey by Statista, 29% of Americans never attend church or synagogue, compared with 23% of Americans who attend every week. According to Christianity Today, 57% of American churches have fewer than 100 people attending services each Sunday, and 21% of American churches average fewer than 50. Around 1 in 10 churches average 250 or more for their worship services. This was pre-quarantine. I cannot imagine what the average attendance is now. I read that between 2006 and 2012, an estimated 30,000 congregations shut the doors to their churches. With the recent pandemic, many churches went online. A survey by the Public Religion Research Institute found that one-third or more of those who had previously attended church regularly were not bothering to watch online services. For those whose church affiliation was already weak, the disconnect may be permanent. Think about it. One-third of the church has slipped away. There are others who have gotten comfortable with watching church online and have not returned to live services. For some, it's because it's more comfortable to stay home, watch the services in pajamas while drinking coffee. For others, the health risks are great enough to legitimately concern them, and for them, online services have been a blessing. For me, it's been a blessing to be able to reach our people wherever they are, and the online services have broadened our ministry. We minister to a good amount of viewers weekly and have gone to online ministry 7 days a week, and it's been a blessing to do so. We broadcast Bible studies 7 days a week. On Monday night, we broadcast our young adult ministry. On Tuesday morning, we show our 6:30 a.m. men's Bible study live. And then in the afternoon, we have our Facebook Live. Tuesday evening, we have a Bible study that's shown. Wednesday night's live service is online. And on Thursday, we have another Facebook Live, as well as a Thursday night Bible study. On Friday night, we have a program featuring my wife, Marie, and me as we minister thoughts on marriage. Saturday, we have an evening service. On Sunday morning, our two morning services are shown at regular times, as well as a rebroadcast that occurs at 2 p.m. Later in the evening, we broadcast a Sunday night service. With that said, I miss having our people gathered together, and I miss being able to see so many who are not with us in our live services. For those who join us online and are unable to be with us for live ministry yet, well, I want to let you know we love you, and we look forward to having you once again with us in person. Because we are thoroughly cleaning our church facilities, I'm confident enough to encourage you to join us for live services. Our children's ministry is properly prepared to care for your children. We have outside seating for those who prefer remaining outside, and We provide masks for those who desire them, as well as sanitizers throughout the campus. We have room for you. I would encourage you to be with us. Perhaps it would be good at this moment to encourage you who watch your church services online to remember that though you're not able to be with your church family, you are missed. I would also remind you that though the economy has gone through an upheaval, your worship of the Lord through your gifts has been truly encouraging and is needed. As mentioned, there are churches that have closed doors because of financial stress. If you love your fellowship and you trust the Lord, I encourage you to continue giving your gifts. They are truly needed at this time. If you're not supporting your church through your gifts, please remember that the church still has financial obligations, building payments, utilities, staff, various needs still need to be met. So may I encourage you to continue giving your support to your church. Some churches have had to close their doors. I do hope this has not happened in the church that you call your home. In the end, we all live by faith, and I encourage you to continue supporting your home church. If this fellowship is your home, remember to support the work. In spite of the shutdown, we still continue making mortgage payments, we pay salaries, and we're reaching out as much as we can. And we still can do that because you have been faithful. So thank you. I look forward to sharing the word with you on Sunday, either here for our live services or online. And again, we've been making sure that we have followed the guidelines for live services, and our children's ministry is carefully caring for your children. If you'd like, you can go online to see what we're presently doing to make this place as safe as possible. I want you to know I miss you. I look forward to having you with us again soon. This is David Rosales, pastor of Calvary Chapel of the Chino Valley, California.